just wondering, I went,
hi there. I was going to get you Norman Collier before that, when I was coming over Crotherson there. But I sort of understood what you said. We'd see you here. I got the message, anyway. I was quite pleased to know everything was going ahead eventually. 1-2, 1-2.
Right, how would everybody like to go and grab a seat?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And was that a black fountain pen?
Will you turn your phone off, by the way?
Oh yeah, sorry James, this is Anne.
Peter, how are you?
This is me too.
So you're both from Ireland?
Yeah.
Right, oh well, we're still a church officer meeting.
This is my bride meeting.
Right. Who's the witness?
Stop
it, West Van.
You've got to come back to the weekend.
You forgot. Shall we just do the rehearsal with that?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Okay.
As you know, we had.
It's an unfortunate mistake. Well, he is. Well, he still turned up.
On the day.
I can show him the video if that helps.
On the day, you can change your witnesses. I can actually score the names in.
Oh, it's got to be here today. It's not his fault, it's our fault.
But I can't score your names in. The witnesses you can change on the day. And the witnesses can be anybody, strangers, as long as they're there watching you, but I can't change your names. So, are we ready to begin?
Yes.
So, who is everybody?
Like, names.
No, just numbers.
I know that Scott is not here. I know that. I met Anne. Yes. Peter, is it?
Yes.
Maureen.
Maureen Mo. I've got Mo here.
Oh, yeah, Mo, that's it. Mo.
Will I call you Maureen or Mo?
Mo.
Mo, right, okay.
And Pauline.
Pauline, right. Nice to meet you.
And Craig, you just met.
Craig, who is.
Doing the poem.
Singing a song for us, is that right?
No, he's reading a poem.
He's reading a poem. Okay.
Caitlin is a flower girl. She's four. Very shy.
Okay, good.
And Jack is Caitlin's brother and he's the page boy.
He's gonna
Jack.
Six.
He's six.
Charm on her.
That's a nice compliment. And that's all
anything
we have.
Else?
That's all at the moment.
Right, okay. So, this wedding is going to take place on Saturday at 1 o'clock on the dot.
Ooh, a little bit on the dot.
Where will you be coming from?
From Tinnand.
Where?
Tinnand.
Tinnand Parks.
Where's that?
Loch of Briggs, far side. Tinnand.
Other side of Loch of Briggs.
Okay, that's fine. Not a problem. Are there any roadworks that day?
I think
the bypass
is
closed again.
It was closed last Saturday.
So I'll have to come through the town.
Who's going to bring
you? What's his name? Ian Falls.
May I highly recommend that you get in touch with him?
Oh no, Vaughan, he's coming at 12. He's coming at 12.
Arriving at house at 12.
To discuss the matter. Because Brian was...
She was quite, 10-15 minutes late last Saturday.
But that's customary anyway, isn't it?
I mean, it's okay.
I don't look too keen.
It's not a problem. It's not a problem you being late. Just that after 10 minutes, everyone starts gossiping. Is she going to turn up?
Well, that's what makes it all.
Well, she's only got 20 minutes in
another way. It may make it interesting, but only ever happens in EastEnders. It seems to happen frequently.
To give them a chance to get to know each other.
But in 33 years, it's never happened to me. But anyway, if you think you're going to be late, give us a wee phone. You know, like more than 10 minutes.
Right,
give us a wee phone.
Phone.
But it really is not a problem. You are allowed to be late.
Right.
But not very late.
I was an hour late
for her wedding.
And I still waited for her.
I still waited for her. But by all the sweating buckets.
I'm sure she was worth waiting for.
Absolutely. We're three and five kids up.
So you'll find out if you're worth waiting for her. You know. So, Martin, you will remember Scott.
Hopefully. If I don't, it's a bad job because I'm staying at his bit on Friday night, so if I forget him, it's a really bad job.
If you could be here 12:30,
we were coming from
12:30, I should be here about 12, I think. We'll
just
be
12 o'clock.
This is going to open up early.
Yep.
And you and Scott are welcome to wander around.
Yep.
Talk to Pope, or if you want, you can sit in the vestry, play cards.
Yeah.
That's what I did tonight. So you can wander around. And then, at about 5:00,
yep,
I'll get hold of you and position you somewhere.
Right.
Probably down in the front here.
Yep.
And at 1:00, Christina.
I want to cut the phone and go, and that means that I'm on a list.
So, what I would like, Peter, are you taking part in this?
No.
Could you stand in as the best one?
If I have, yes.
So, if you, Peter, come and stand here, and Martin, I want you to stand just there.
Right.
Just sort of in line with this, that's the centre line. So you really want to be very, very close over a bit. That's excellent. Okay?
I'm not having pockets on the day, don't worry.
It's allowed to relax.
I was just
thinking. Do you know what you're in for?
No.
There's still time.
You're finding out.
Is that the only thing you did for life?
Well, they say you don't know what happiness is until you're married, and then it's too late. You know that one. So this will be when I want Scott to stand, okay?
Yep.
And as I said, what I'll actually do is when Christina arrives, arrives out there, I'll actually speak to the congregation to let her know they've arrived. And then I will go up and sort the bridal party.
Mm-hmm.
Then I will come out and invite you and Scott to stand exactly where you are.
Yep.
Okay? And then I will invite the congregation to stand for the bride. Okay?
Where are the ushers and that be?
Who are the ushers?
Greg's going to say that.
Well, what relationship are the ushers to you two?
My sons.
Oh, well.
But Ryan's going to be away first.
That's,
7 girls and 2 boys.
Right. Okay. Are they all coming?
Everyone and all the nieces and nephews.
Right. Can you even guess how many we're talking about?
There's 74. Oh, no, you mean close family?
Yes.
17 on the bus coming tomorrow,
yes.
And there's 5 of us, which is
22. I'd say it'll be about 32, 33.
Right. And that's your side of the family?
Yeah, yeah.
What about your side of the family? 3.
It was very quiet, wasn't it?
get off the
bus. Turn to
everyone.
Turn to everyone. Not anyone. It does happen. Actually, when that happens, which does happen, we ask the ushers to split them.
Because
I mean, really,
it'd be nice to mix them up,
wouldn't it? Well, yes. So, seriously, do you know how many from your side, including friends, might be coming?
Well, there's going to be 74 in total.
74
in total.
But your side of the
family.
Well,
it's going to be roughly half and half, isn't it?
No, it's your family.
Your nearest.
Oh, my family.
Your family.
Your granny, 5, 6.
7, 8, 9, 15, okay. Right, well, a 3 pews for you, 6 pews for you, that's absolutely fine. Well, I'll just point out to the ushers, what the ushers need to know is family, right? Because traditionally at weddings, family are down at the front.
Yeah.
Unless there's anyone new born.
I'll be floating about in the room.
Okay. But we will make sure that the guests are in the balance.
Yeah, okay.
That's
oh, yeah.
But one usher's your son, so he's giving you away.
Yes.
And then he will sit there. That's usually when the.
Beside
you. Whoever gives. Beside your mum?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Would that be okay?
Yeah, perfect.
Or is there anyone else special to your son?
No, my mum would be great.
Right. Then your mum should be here,
right.
And that seat will be reserved for Ryan.
Oh.
Okay? And that's the son's giving away. Who are the other ushers?
My other son, Dale.
Right.
Where would he sit?
Well, probably the third back. Is that okay?
Yeah, whatever.
Are you sure? And I think, oh no, you'll be out of here. Oh, well, you have a son there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what we can do is kind of reserve these 6 for them.
Right.
Okay. Who is the other principal usher?
Your brother.
Brother.
Your brother. Oh, yes. Who else have you, who else is in your closest family? This, your brother Scott.
Mum.
Your mum and dad. Any grandparents?
Two granddads and their granddad.
On your side? Right. Well, they'll be in here.
Right.
I would suggest your other brother could be here.
Oh,
no,
one brother.
He's got the one Scott, it's just the one brother.
Oh, sorry, who's the other usher?
Dale.
Sorry.
Dale.
Who's
Dale?
My other son.
So, Ryan's. Right, wait.
Ryan's going to be an usher and give you.
Sorry.